Hi friends. This morning we're going over to see the petroglyphs at Painted Rock, Arizona. Please enjoy my stories or whatever else might be on my mind today.
Continue for 11 miles.
It's the Solana Generating Station. This is the biggest solar array I've ever seen. I've passed it for miles to this point, and it appears that it goes miles ahead. There's a feedlot. This is the third one of these I've seen. Some of the biggest feedlots I've ever seen. Lots of cows. And the solar array just keeps going. Hay for cows. Probably baled alfalfa. We're on our way to Painted Rock Campground. It's 11 miles off of I-8. Not the best road, but we made it. Got the awning out and got Miss Lynn sitting in the shade. Watch out for rattlesnakes. I think it's a little early in the year. They're still hibernating. One scary thing I did see in the desert was this really tall guy. Speaking of scary things in life, how did we get here from here? That would be a long story. Let's get an overview of the area. This mound down here is where all of the painted rocks are. I don't know why they call it painted rock. It should be called painted rocks. Many, many, many of those rocks down there, and they're bigger than they look from up here, are painted, or not actually painted, kind of designs, animals, etc., scratched into them with probably another rock. There's a little pavilion there and a day use bathroom. And we'll fly out here a ways, a mile or so. I never noticed these tracks down here in the desert before until I was editing this video. Somebody's been doing donuts with their ATVs down there, leaving intaglios for people who will look at that in the 35th century after we're all gone and say, oh, looky there. The ancients, maybe they were depicting, what, an eclipse. See how the circles are convergent? Ha. This road keeps going, and apparently out here on these other hills over here to the left are some more painted rocks, but I didn't go over there. You can see there's a lot of camping area here, and it's very dispersed, being in the sense that they aren't very close together. I flew out here to the end of the campground. Yeah, that one there looks like the last one. He's got some solar. Coming back, I decided to practice my piloting skills and see if I could follow the curves in this road. hard left turn. Actually, I turned too hard and got confused a little bit. I thought I was on the road to the right, so I'm looking for my RV and, oh, there it is, way over there. Well, let's go take a walk over there towards that pavilion and look at the big rocks. Well, it's a pavilion. It says no camping here. That's me way over there. And out here, 11 miles from the middle of nowhere, there's a book exchange. Take one, leave one. The pile of rocks you see in front of you are basalt. It's a granite outcropping covered by these basalt rocks, and how they got piled up that way, I don't know, but I do know that they're all covered with what's called desert varnish. When basalt weathers from the rain and the wind and the sun and the alkali in the desert dust blowing on them, it gets a dark covering. So it's a perfect medium for the petroglyph artists. They just scratch off the dark part and the lighter basalt underneath shows up as the design. There are lots of different symbols. This one here is a man with interlocking hands, a lizard, snakes, deer, sun, turtle, scorpion, snake, sun, moon, maze, rattlesnake. So, who made these petroglyphs? It's thought to be the Odham people. They're the ancients of the Tohono O'odham Native American people of the Sonoran Desert and the state of Arizona. It's a federally recognized Native American nation. The designs indicate a diverse and interesting culture. O'odham in their native language means desert people. The people that made these designs knew what they were meaning, but we don't. They've expressed their cultural experiences and their visions and probably their dreams. Only they knew what they mean, and we can only guess. Probably some of the designs were warnings for travelers about what might be on down the trail. Others might be a reminder of what's happened in the past so that their children in the future do not forget. I feel compelled to interpret this one for you myself. When the sun comes out, the scorpions are active, and you better run away fast. And I'll let you interpret the three-legged man yourself. I'm always curious to know if petroglyphs were actually as old as it's reported that they are. These are dated, so I'm assuming that these are graffiti left by passersby long after the O'odham people did the original designs. This has been Painted Rock, Arizona. It was recommended by our friends Janet and Waylon, who live in Yuma, and I'm glad we stopped. It's 11 miles off of Interstate 8 between Tucson and Yuma near Gila Bend. The campground was nice. It was $8 a night, half price $4 if you have the America the Beautiful card. Very striking bus. Hey, if you like me, give me one of those thumbs up. And please subscribe and hit that little bell so you know when I post next. Please share me with your friends on social media. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed what was on my mind today.